Bows his head and maneuvers comfortably into the position he knows so well. And then, out of his shoulder holster she comes, like a band of angels in holy chorus. Christy is her name and destruction is her game. Crowder points his beloved Dan Wesson large frame, .44 Magnum, given to him by his mother on her deathbed, at the butane gas cylinders in front of him.
That's a mighty fine weapon, Hurricane.
Her name is Christy. She delivers justice every time, baby.
That's a beautiful name for courage.
My mother was a beautiful woman. She gave it to me right before she died. Kept it under her pillow. I feel like she's with me every time I use it.
I love you, Hurricane.
Now while I'm working, she will.
Crowder gives Stero a little wink before firing his weapon with ease. 1, 2, 3, The doctor suddenly engulfed like a 4th of July celebration. Devastation raises itself into the midnight sky. Stella runs for cover, but the Hurricane just watches his work with pride. He turns, Christy at his side, and he walks away from the burning inferno behind him. This guy just oozes cool.
What the hell is your problem, Crowder?
Just doing my job, Captain.
Why do you have to blow everything up, for Christ's sake?
Their own fault for hiding in the butane gas warehouse. Not only were they dealing angel dust in our great city, but they were goddamn fools.
This mess is gonna cost the taxpayer a hell of a lot! How the hell do I explain this? How the hell do I explain you?
Sometimes you gotta see beyond the cash, Captain White. It's the human lives I'm interested in. Yes, I destroyed a city block, 14 cars, a garbage truck, and a senator's yacht. But most importantly, I saved a generation of kids who would have been hooked on PCP. Tell that to your taxpayers, man. Tell that to the families of kids already taken by drugs.
I guess you're right, Josh.
I'm always right.
Wait a second! What? Yeah!
Oh my God, Hurricane, that was some show. Only you can look so good walking away from a burning building.
It's called timing, baby. I like to do things with style.
Will you call me, Hurricane?
Tell you what, Stella. How about you call me?
Crowder gives Stella his classic smile as he turns and walks away. The camera cranes into the air as Josh the Hurricane Crowder becomes a tiny speck in the city streets. Fade out. The end. What do you think, Mary?
It's not very good, really.
What? But his greatest adventure yet?
It's so cliched. Didn't you see me cringe?
I thought that was excitement.
Believe me, it wasn't. Why'd you write this crap, Billy? You're better than this.
I write it because I enjoy writing it. I thought you loved the Hurricane.
I did at first. I enjoyed the first one because it was a funny homage to the films you love. But this is number 13, for God's sake.
I love him.
Write some new stuff, original stuff. Send it out, get it seen, sold. Forget this rubbish, Billy. You're wasting your time.
You don't understand. This is my life.
I thought I was your life.
You are. I love you.
I think you love Hurricane more.
You're real, Mary. Besides, why the hell would I be in love with a 6'3" black man?
He is a bit cool. Would you like to be like him?
Pretty difficult being a 5'8" white man from Liverpool.
Well, you're my Hurricane. Is Stella based on me? She's glamorous, witty, gorgeous, Tell me she's based on me, Billy.
Pam Grier with a little Tamara Dobson thrown in.
Well, thanks a bloody lot.
What?
You could have lied.
I'm only joking.
Well, I'm off. Your mum and dad will be home soon.
Stay for tea. Mum will love it. She'll make cakes.
We need to talk about this, Billy. It's just not right.
What's not right?
You, me, all this. Your obsession with Foxy Coffee or whatever her bloody name is. We need to talk about us, where we're going. And most importantly, we need to talk about you. Why the hell is a 38-year-old man still living at home with his parents?
It's Foxy Brown. Mary! Mary! Damn.
So what have you been doing with yourself, son?
Nothing much, Dad. Bit of writing, you know.
You don't speak to us much about your writing these days. In one of your serious writing phrases.
Don't start on him, Frank.
I'm not starting on anything, love. I'm asking him a question. I'm trying to start up a bit of conversation with my son.
I've been looking at a few jobs online.
There you go. Music to my ears. Now, I wouldn't have found that out without a bit of chatter over an evening meal. We must do this more often.
Have you really, Billy?
Have a what, Mum?
Been looking for work.
Of course he bloody hasn't. He's only saying that so he can eat his steak in peace.
I have, honestly.
What jobs then? Go on. Tell me what work you put yourself forward for.
I haven't put myself forward for anything, Dad. I've just been looking.
Well, what kind of jobs have you been looking for then? Go on. I'm trembling with anticipation.
The council are after people. Parks and gardens or something.
Nope. Scratch that one off straight away. Parks and gardens generally require lifting and stuff. Bit of digging, maybe. Hard graft. That's you out of the running right there. Early starts too. Throw that idea right out of your head, sonny. Next.
Stop it, Frank.
There's a journalism course I'd like to do.
Another course?
Your mother got there before me with that one.
You've done a few courses, haven't you, love?
How many is he finished? Oh, let me see now.
They just haven't been right for me.
You want to be a writer, yeah? Do I know that much about what goes on in that black hole of yours upstairs?
Yes.
Right, good. Well, this is what you do. Now, I'm no expert here, but I'll throw these pearls of wisdom right at you and hope I hit you with maybe just one. Ready?
Frank.
How about you take one of those scripts of yours, maybe the best one, put it in a large envelope and send the bloody thing off somewhere. Maybe that would increase your chances of actually selling something. Because the thing is, Ben, I don't really think that these top Hollywood producer folk actually knock door to door to see if anyone's got anything available.
I'm afraid of the rejection.
Oh, come on, for God's sake. You're 38 years of age, lad. This is the problem, Phyllis. You've kept him wrapped up for so too long. He hasn't had to use his balls in the world, so they've buggered off on him.
Frank, we're at the dinner table.
Oh, look. See what? His bollocks just rolled past the window.
Thanks for the vote of confidence.
Vote of confidence? To do that, we need you to be doing something that you can have confidence in.
Screw you,
Billy.
No, leave it, love. That's what I like. A bollock might just be on its way back.
You want me to move out?
20 years ago, yeah.
We just worry about you.
I'll get it.
Make sure you don't break a nail on the way.
Frank.
Oh, he gives me a bloody headache.
Yes.
How's it going, my man?
Can I help you?
Billy, right? Billy Webster?
Yeah.
I'm Joshua Crowder.
What?
You never heard of me, dude?
Who's put you up to this? Mary.
Let's grab all this boy. Inside.
What the hell's going on? I just need to back up in a little. Oh.
Who is this Billy? Friend of yours?
How you doing, Pop?
Who's this man, Billy?
Dad, this is,
I'm Nathan Renfield, Mr. Webster. I work for American Independent Global Pictures Incorporated. You've heard of us?
I can't say I'm Mr. Renfield.
Well, we make movies. Your son here sent us a wonderful script a few months back, and it was just great. I mean, it was just an outstanding piece of writing. We just loved it.
You didn't mention this, Billy.
You didn't mention this, Billy? You didn't mention this wonderful nugget of news to your folks? Shit, man, that's lame. You're a very attractive woman there, Mrs. Webster.
Thank you, Mr. Renfield. Would you like some dinner with us?
Well, I've actually just eaten, but that's a beautiful offer from a beautiful woman. Please, call me Josh.
I thought you said your name was Nathan.
Josh Nathan Renfield, that's me, sir. I go by many names. Josh, Joshua, Nathan. Hell, my mom just called me boy.
So, you want to buy my son's story? His script?
Well, what we like to do is work with him. You see, I don't think this fine figure of a man here has reached his full potential yet. That's why I've been sent.
Will my son be taken to America?
No way, Mrs. Webster. I ain't taking your boy anywhere.
Wonderful. Please call me Phyllis.
He'd be willing to go to America. We could pay.
Frank!
Phyllis, what a wonderful name that is. I hear Phyllis and it conjures up visions of rose petals to me. How the hell haven't you got more children, Frankie? If this fine specimen of a feminine beauty was mine, I would be making babies with her all year round.
So what do you want, Mr. Renfield?
What I'd like to do, with your permission of course, is to stay a few days and monitor your son's work. See if he really has the potential to make it in Tinseltown. What do you say?
Well, we don't have an awful lot of room here.
I'm sure I could bunk in with Bill for a few days. I'm sure he wouldn't mind, Bill. It will be fun. What do you say?
It shouldn't be a problem, Frank.
I promise to keep my paws off your lovely wife, too. Tough as it is, man.
You really think our son has talent?
You don't see what he's got often in his lifetime, people. There are those who can and those who can't. Your son is definitely in the latter section.
We tried to bring him up well. He's our only child.
Unfortunately.
That's the thing, Phyllis. He's an only child. You put in that time, the effort. You've made him what he is. Now me, I never had that luxury.
Why is that?
Well, you see, I was the third brother of five, doing whatever I had to do to survive. I'm not saying what I did was all right. Trying to break out of the ghetto was a day-to-day fight.
I think we need to talk, Nathan.
Damn right, Billy. Tell you what, guys, Billy and I will go and have a chat about contracts and stuff. You two open a bottle of wine or something, cuddle, have a celebration. We'll be right back.
We have that book space from Mavis's wedding in the cupboard.
Let's go, Billy.
What the hell is going on?
That was me undercover routine, man. See the way I just evolved into a new character? Well, hell, you taught me how to do that shit.
You can't be Joshua Crowther. You know why?
Lay it on me, dude.
Because Joshua Crowther doesn't exist.
Then explain this.
Oh my God.
Ain't she cool? Look at the way your downstairs toilet light reflects off her chrome, man.
Christy?
A beauty, ain't she?
Exactly how I wrote her.
I also have a 13-inch dick, but you won't want to see that down, do you?
What the hell is that?
My wheels.
What the hell is that?
I've had exhaust problems all day.
Phone the fire brigade, Phyllis!
Where's the number?
Oh, for God's sake!
You could just be some wacko who's read my scripts.
Why? Why would I do that? Besides, you never let anyone see them. Plus, I know shit you've never even written. I know all the crap about me locked away in that head of yours. You're already thinking about Detroit for my next job.
What's going on, Hurricane?
I'm the biggest badass in the whole of New York City, Billy. You know that better than anybody. You mess with the Hurricane and the Hurricane takes you down. Half the city loves me, worships me, but the other half want me dead. There's only one way they can do that, man. Only one way they can get to me.
Stella?
You.
Me? But that's impossible. How can they get to me? They don't exist. I created every enemy you have.
I'm here, which means they're here. Grab some things and let's move out.
Did you really just quote Bobby Womack in there?
Hey man, you stole it from me. Yeah, Chase Johnson Lynch, Joshua Crowther, the Hurricane Lady.
Suzanne Roach, Mary Castle, and Stella.
Paul Hilt, Billy Webster. Famous Sturgeon.
Noel Ross, Captain White, and Fred Webster.
Boom, chicka wah wah!
Had to do it.